right down to cancer, Eric. I mean, the big C scares the pants off me. I don't think I'm alone in that because, you know, my father died of melanoma at the age of 63. I have so many people around me who have had cancer, have it now, or have battled it, and it is a beast. So let's talk about casein, which is inherent in dairy products. Tell us what casein is and how does it create and propagate cancer.
I have family members who currently have cancer. They had breast cancer. My aunt had it 20 years ago. Her daughter had the BRCA genes and she had breast cancer. And I have a very close friend who's an MD who has breast cancer, and neither of them are open to changing their diet whatsoever. So here's an MD that's educated. Here's a family member who knows what I teach and what I do, who would think, maybe the love and compassion that I have for her, she would change her life. And with both of them with breast cancer, the first thing I think about is dairy. Casein makes up 80% of dairy protein. Dairy protein is made up of two different ones, casein and whey, and dairy is primarily casein protein. Well, research in the 1960s and 1970s has shown that casein is one of the strongest tumor promoters. There's some research now suggesting that casein may be a co-carcinogen. Now, a carcinogen is what causes your cells to mutate. We're always mutating our genes. It's constantly happening. And if you eat a plant-based diet, your repair systems work much better. We're getting these mutations. Well, if you're drinking dairy, one glass, two glasses, three glasses, not only are you helping to speed up those mutations as a co-carcinogen, it doesn't cause the mutation, but it speeds it up. And then as a tumor promoter, it speeds up the process of that tumor going from a very small mass to becoming malignant and metastasizing and going throughout your body. And people aren't aware, even in the medical community, of the detrimental effects of casein.